Hey guys, I've been beta testing the Starlink system for about 6 months, and in this video I'll share what the equipment looks like, how to get the Starlink app, and demo how it works. Then I'll share the results of my experience using Starlink in a place surrounded by towering trees.
The box is here. I'm going to open it, share what it looks like inside. Quick diagram showing you what to do. Very simple. Packed very nicely. And here we have the tripod supported. Here's the dish. The dish is flat. And I understand that it gives off heat. So up here in Michigan where it snows a lot, we will be able to test that out and see if it keeps the snow off the dish during the winter. Ample amount of cable here to run it wherever you're going. Power supply already connected up in the router. Just a little bit more information. This is the power supply. It has two inputs. They're cabled white and black, so you pretty much can figure that out. The white one goes to the router, which is very futuristic looking. On the back, it has an aux input. Now what I plan to do is to hook my mesh network that I already have in the house into that and see if that will boost the coverage.
Before you order Starlink, you need to download the Starlink app from the Google App Store or the iPhone equivalent. Type in Starlink in the search field in the App Store, then download and install the app. A newly installed app has a feature called Check for Obstructions. It will give you an idea what blockages are on your property. Pressing Check for Obstructions uses the phone camera to view what obstructions exist within a circle displayed on the screen. So go to where you think you will install your dish. The screen will tell you which direction to move your phone to show the sky from that location. The dish arrives in a stowed position and automatically points itself when you power up. If the results aren't good for the location you've selected, the app can return the dish to the stowed position. Then you can unplug the system before moving the dish. When you move the dish the first time to a new position and plug it in, the dish will unlock and face straight up towards the sky in about 5 or so minutes. In the flat position, once it detects a satellite signal, it moves the dish to the correct angle for continuous communication. Unlike other satellite services, the dish aligns itself. Unfortunately, being surrounded by forest, finding a good location for the dish proved difficult, as it seemed to change every time a new set of satellites launched into space and orbits were reconfigured. That required stowing the dish, unplugging the system, and trying various places to find a better signal. I experienced high speeds in the 150s initially, but that lowered to the 30s, 40s, and 50s as time and satellite positions changed. Still, those are far better than speeds found in competitors. In winter, with no leaves on the trees and snow on the ground, I placed the dish on top of a 4-foot wall of snow, and we had a good enough signal to watch Netflix, Prime, and YouTube without much buffering. Then came spring, and trees began to repopulate their branches, and the signal slowly got worse as I had expected. Moving the dish didn't do much good, so I resorted to using items from the garage to raise the height of the dish. That improved reception, but the updated Starlink app now showed that the signal was interrupted every 46 seconds. That's right, 46 seconds, by obstructions, and still we were able to get a signal, but with buffering, on streaming services. Not wishing to install dish mounts on various spots on the roof, only to find that the reception was poor. A spot was selected on the roof in that general area, allowing the tripod support stand to maintain a stable position. The initial results showed the ping data in the statistics, signal bouncing percentage, to stabilize around 100%, and the time between blockages went from 46 seconds to 6 minutes. All buffering on the streaming channels disappeared. With blockages, Zoom calls will disconnect often, and online gaming is definitely out of the question. Before I forget, if this has been useful to you, please click the like button. Appreciate it. For me, the roof mount provides ping responses far better than anything on the ground, and presumably when the leaves fall from the trees in the autumn, the signals will improve. It all seems to depend on the flight path of the satellites as they move across the northern sky. but it is better than any other option we have out here in the forest. Good luck if you decide to order the Starlink beta kit, but remember that beta testing will still have blockages even if you have a clear sky. Thanks for watching.